4. Andronikos Komnenos was the second-born son of the Komneni. Alexios, at a young age, gifted Andronikos with the court title of Sevastokrator. At 1116, Andronikos participated in the famous Battle of Philomelion, where Alexios marched against the Seljuk Turks. Andronikos, at the side of his father, had the chance to show his warlike virtues. In the battle, he slew many Turks and even conquered the royal tent of the Seljuk Sultan himself. Andronikos was the darling brother of his sister Anna and offered his support to his brother-in-law, Nikephoros Vrienios, in the coup against their brother John. After the failure of the plot, John forgave Andronikos and allowed him to remain in the court. Later, Andronikos assisted John in his wars with the Hungarians and the Pechenegs. In 1122, in the Battle of Veria, in the final skirmish between the Romans and the Pechenegs, it has been noted that Andronikos fell like a storm under the Turks and played an important role in the crushing Roman victory, in a time when there was no hope. Andronikos died from a terrible disease that left him a skeleton. The Dowager Empress Irene Duchena, accompanied by her son-in-law Nikephoros Vrienios, transported the lifeless body of her son from Asia Minor to the capital in a ship. In the magnificent funeral of Andronikos wept all the people of Constantinople, while all the institutions of the state, the courtists, the senate, the church, the army, came to pay their respects. Andronikos was pious, abstinent, and led an ascetic lifestyle. Someone wrote that even the nations that Andronikos had subdued as a soldier grieved for his death. The Rhetor Michael Italicos calls him a live statue of Mars and adds that after his passing, the army was left dead without a heart. Andronikos married one Russian princess of exceptional beauty, a daughter of Volodar, the ruler of Premsil. Five. Isaac Komnenos was the third-in-line son of Alexios. At a young age, his father gifted him with the court title of Caesar. Isaac supported his brother John against the aspirations of his sister Anna, and for this choice he was honored later with the title of Sevastokrator. John loved his younger brother dearly, and there was always space for Isaac in his table. However, Isaac betrayed his trust, and in 1130, he organized a plot against him while John was campaigning against the Turks. The schemes of Isaac failed, and in order to save his life, he chose to exile himself far from Constantinople. Isaac spent many of his years in the lands of the East, attempting to forge alliances with all the enemies of the Roman Empire, the Muslims of Asia Minor, the Sultan of Iconium, the Armenians of Cilicia, and the Latins of the East. Isaac hoped that they would march against the Roman Empire and install him as emperor in Constantinople. However, John achieved great victories against both Turks and Latins and conquered Antioch. With all his allies paralyzed, Isaac appeared in front of John's army, asking his friendship, something that John offered with great pleasure. But Isaac kept conspiring against his brother, and this time John exiled him at Pontus in Heraclea Pontica. During the reign of his nephew Manuel, Isaac still kept his eyes on the imperial crown, but his ambitions were never fulfilled. After 1150, this Komnenos, now sick, started to lose his passion for kingship, and it appears that Isaac started to worry for his sins and his afterlife salvation. Thus, he concentrated his efforts at founding a personal monastery that he devoted to Theotokos Kosmosoteida. In the abbey he founded, there was also a hospital for all people in need. Isaac is the father of the future emperor, Andronikos Komnenos, who was killed in the Hippodrome by the hands of the outraged citizens of Constantinople. Thanks for watching our video. Subscribe to our channel and please support us on Patreon by following the link in the description.